Conclusion: implications for illicit labor markets and economic rehabilitation. One, programs often assume that former fighters and other high-risk young men are uninterested in traditional occupations like farming. But young men in Liberia understand farming is the main economic opportunity. Two, one-time transfer of skills and capital may have limited deterrent effects on future violence. Conditioning on location may be more effective. Three, employment programs should emphasize capital alongside skills. Four, the elasticity of legal labor supply suggests the returns to illicit behaviors were not much greater than agriculture to begin with. Implications for theories of armed recruitment. Armed recruitment responds to material incentives. Implications for rehabilitation strategies. Try other ways to do this. On to another post-Civil War country, Sierra Leone. Reconciling after civil conflict increases social capital but decreases individual well-being. Jacob Silaris, Oyendrila Dube, and Bilal Sidiqui. Truth and Reconciliation Programs. Truth and Reconciliation Programs have become a common approach for rebuilding social ties and promoting healing among communities in the aftermath of war. The researchers evaluate a Truth and Reconciliation Program run by a nonprofit, Fambul Talk, in Sierra Leone. Fambul Talk selected 100 sections of 10 villages each for their program. The researchers selected 50 treatment, 50 control. The program was rolled out and evaluated in waves because of capacity constraints. Two waves happened. The third was canceled midway through because of the Ebola crisis. What is this Truth and Reconciliation Program? One, Fambul Talk consulted with village chiefs for support of the project. Two, several months of community organization, training in trauma healing and meditation, outreach to encourage victims and perpetrators to participate in the truth-telling process. Three, these activities culminated in a two-day-long bonfire ceremony where victims shared their stories and perpetrators asked for forgiveness for their war crimes. The ceremony incorporated traditional and religious rituals, including prayers and dancing. Four, to continue community healing after the ceremony, Fambul Talk set up a symbolic peace tree in each village and in some areas communal farms. In addition, it helped establish a peace mothers group to promote women's economic activities and discuss gender targeted atrocities perpetuated during the war. This is intense but not uncommon. The context: Sierra Leone post-Civil War. As you remember from past lectures, Sierra Leone was in a civil war from 1991 to 2001. During this time, 50,000 people were killed, 2.6 million people were displaced, 4 million total. Much of the violence was neighbor on neighbor within village. There were child soldiers. After the war, the government did their own truth and reconciliation, but only in city centers and at a small scale. Fambul Talk was started in 2007 to fill this gap. Results: science has such nice tables. The impact of reconciliation on forgiveness and trust. Table 2, reconciliation and social networks. Table 3, reconciliation and participation in community groups. Table 4, reconciliation and contribution to public goods. Table 5, and psychological.